because at this point, the royal family will probably try and kick me out of the country, considering all the jokes that I make about them. But I just don't care. I don't actually care because, you know, colonialism, commonwealth, but the wealth ain't common. Think about it. Hey, sorry, my bad. I was just watching my favourite black artist, Jesse Nelson, you know, performing on my favourite black-owned radio station, Radar Radio. Which actually leads me to my first point of this video. Genuine question here. If you're watching this and you're under the age of 25, do you actually listen to the radio anymore? I need answers because I'm genuinely curious, right? And I've got to choose my words very carefully here because my actual job, as in my actual day job, is a radio producer. I work in radio, but other than racist people calling in on LBC to complain about immigration and wanting their country back.
But you will never be English. You are African Caribbean.
But why will I never be English?
Because you're African Caribbean.
Sometimes I feel like radio is dead. And then on other times, I feel like it comes back to life, like Prince Philip. Oh, wait. Oh, wrong prince. My bad. And on that note, let me just cross my name off the list of people that will potentially get an OBE or a knighthood in future. Because at this point, the royal family will probably try and kick me out of the country, considering all the jokes that I make about them. But I just don't care. I don't actually care because, you know, colonialism, commonwealth, but the wealth ain't common. Think about it. I'm going off on a tangent again. Sorry. Right. Where was I? Today, I want to discuss the important role that radio has played in pushing black music to the forefront in this country. And there is a lot to discuss. Once again, just for clarification, because we will genuinely be here all day if we spoke about everything that's happened in black history over the years, I am only focusing on the things that have happened from the year 2000 onwards till today. So, shout out to all the pirate radio crew them. You know, if I was to list all the radio stations and all of the DJs from that era, it will take forever. And maybe, just maybe, Prince Andrew would actually be convicted in that time. It's not like he's effectively being protected by taxpayers' money. But what do I know anyways?
Westwood up in the building, Wiley special guest. Now, before we jump into the epic freestyle with Ice Kid, Chipmunk, you know, representing the young'uns up in here.
Not to age myself, but I grew up in a time where radio was super, super important. And radio is the sole reason why I have such a vast and eclectic taste in music. It genuinely was my education. Like, I vividly remember sitting in my dad's car at a very young age, listening to Heart FM. Club classics, this is hard. And they were playing, I can't believe I did that. They were playing the likes of Luther Vandross, Stevie Wonder, Sister Sledge, and many, many others. And I can't lie, I just fell in love. From that point, all I ever wanted was to be a radio presenter. Radio was so important because it gave a voice and a platform to an often marginalized community. There is a generation growing up right now that will have no clue what Choice FM is. It's mad. And it's a shame it no longer exists because Choice FM's legacy, in my opinion, isn't really spoken about enough. It was the first fully licensed radio station in the UK that played 100% black music 24 hours of the day. I'm talking reggae, I'm talking hip hop, I'm talking Afrobeats, I'm talking dancehall. None of that dance stuff and none of that oomph music that Capital Xtra likes to do. And we're going to get onto them and we're going to get onto that a little bit later. But Choice FM was the heartbeat of black British music. And it brought a community together. Even down to the adverts they ran on the station, they were all for local black businesses in Brixton and the surrounding area of South London. And while we're here, we obviously cannot forget some of the legendary DJs on the station. DJs such as Daddy Ernie, Martin J, Natty B, and the Queen herself, the woman with the best voice to ever grace the airwaves, the Lady of Soul, Miss Jenny Francis. She could make butter. Just listen to her. Just listen to her.
Mmm, it certainly is. Title cut to the album Never Too Late. This is Big Bob.
Unfortunately, Choice FM no longer exists. Well, it does, but you know how the story goes when something is black and successful. You know, a rich white person sat in the ivory tower somewhere, saw black people having a good time and thought to themselves, I'm going to ruin everything. I'm going to ruin everything. I'm going to buy that radio station and I'm going to change its name because I can. And not only that, I have the money, meaning I can do whatever I like. That, ladies and gentlemen, is what I like to call cultural colonization. And it's funny because history has a weird way of repeating itself. And for the record, right, I need to let this be known. I don't hate white people. I don't hate white people. Why would I? It's just good comedic content. You guys aren't that bad after all, you know? Other than the little bits of racism here and there and the ignorance and the playing the victim card all the time. You guys are all right. You're all right. I mean, I like the way you guys struggle to find rhythm. And I like the way you guys season chicken.
Is it peanut? Is it canola?
First,
is it vegetable?
We're gonna start with seasoning our chicken.
And you gonna season them with salt. Wow.
Make sure your chicken is nice and seasoned.
I think that joke pretty much writes itself for that one. Okay, back to the story. As of 2013, Choice FM was no more and was replaced with the amazing, wonderful, and culturally relevant Capital Xtra. I sometimes wonder what the creative meeting was like when they decided to rename the station. It probably went something like this.
Oh, I know. Let's call it Capital Xtra. Actually, let's call it Capital Xtra, but without the E. So X-T-R-A, you know, gotta make it urban, but not too urban, but still urban enough to keep the black people coming in and listening to the station.
Can't lie, I don't really want to talk about that station because A, we don't have the time, and B, I don't really care anyway. But shout out to them, man, though. Keep doing your thing. Keep doing your thing.
Doing your thing. I'm a single baby mothers. They're doing the thing.
Now, the station I do have time for, in my opinion, is the real Xtra. The only Xtra we recognise around here. One Xtra.
One Xtra, a new digital radio station from the BBC dedicated to new black music.
Now, as I said before in previous videos, it's super important to have the right people fronting the right content to the right demographic. For example, you would never see me on a Bollywood show. Never. Why? Because I am not a part of that community and I have no knowledge of that world whatsoever. It sounds like common sense, but like J-Hoss, it's not always common sense. I've got to big up the BBC because with One Xtra, they got it right. They really got it right. In fact, they got it bang on the money. In 2002, One Xtra, the national radio station, was launched on the BBC, playing strictly, and I say strictly, black music.
One Xtra, available on DAB digital radio.
So hear me out, yeah? There are probably a lot of young people watching this right now thinking, okay, who cares? But once again, I really do have to emphasise the importance of radio in the early 2000s and the early 2010s. Culturally, it brings the music, the artists and the personalities to life. And we only got to look at Dottie's Breakfast Show as a prime example of this.
That's where you should have dropped the mic, Ellen.
Okay. Production, maybe we shouldn't use any videos of Ellen. Because, you know, cancel culture, yeah? Okay, how about this video? Put this video in.
It says in the title of the movie, what were you actually like when you went to school for real?
Oh, God, time? I was actually a cool kid, man.
Okay, maybe let's not use any Kevin Hart either, because, same again, cancel culture. Let's just move on. Cancel culture has played a massive role in radio recently, and we still have to speak about Radar Radio, but we're gonna get to that very, very soon. Because to say it very lightly, there was a lot of higgy hagger going over there. But we're gonna park that, and we're gonna go back to One Xtra for now.
What's going on?
Radio 1.
What are you little interns doing in your studio? What, you think you can just take over? Get up, get out my seat.
Okay, sorry about.
And you've been on my phone as well.
One Xtra for me filled the void that Choice FM left behind, and they did it in the digital age as well. Now, I know the next individual I'm going to mention isn't black, but a man that has put on for the scene for quite a number of years now is Charlie Sloth. And arguably, his platform, Fire in the Booth, gave the station some real iconic moments in British music history. For example, we've got Bugsy Malone's Fire in the Booth, which led to the whole Chip, Tiny Tempah, Yuggin, and Bugsy entanglement, or whatever you want to call it. There's Rex 32 and Avelino's Fire in the Booth, which is genuinely, to this day, still my favourite Fire in the Booth of all time. And rumour has it, Avelino is still nodding his head.
Just to divide my people. You go from stepping on roaches to stepping by the Beatles. It's progression at its finest. They say
and then on the comedic side of things, who can forget Rosé's Fire in the Booth, which still gets clipped up to this day.
Back in the day, me and you, baby, we used to have fun until we delivered that baby. Look, that's not my son. Believe me, anybody can't tell me that that is my son. Why? Aye, big man, stop doing that. I'm not going to talk to you if you guys get me kind of mad.
And for me, one of the most iconic moments in One Extra's history is this.
The thing goes grrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrr
boom. Skia. Boom, boom. Boom, boom. You're done now. Big Shaq.
Fam, this broke the internet. This broke the internet. And I can't really think of anything else that has had an impact like this before. It went around the world and back, and it basically catapulted Michael Dapper to absolute stardom. As well as that, obviously, kudos to Michael Dapper. It also gave One Xtra the most clicks and arguably the most attention that they've probably ever had before. BBC Radio One Xtra is a staple in Black British music culture, but the local stations was where the magic was really happening. How about this one? Okay, how about this one? Knock, knock. Who's there? Not Madeline Mechanic. Okay, I'm a bastard. And I deserve to be cancelled. But, you know, something fishy's going on over there.